Australian investors can breathe a sigh of relief at the end of a week of wild swings on the share market.
TEN's Natasha Exelby joins us from the Stock Exchange. Tash, a bumpy ride. How did we end up today?
We ended up in the black just by a whisker, Bill, and that's following one of the most volatile weeks we've seen in the share market's history. This morning started really well, and that was largely due to that remarkable rally we saw in Wall Street overnight and some relatively good news coming out of Europe. So, yes, we did end the week on top. But these figures are far from healthy figures. Those issues in Europe and the US with debt, deficit, political unrest, those are not problems that are going away anytime soon. So these swings and roundabouts we're seeing on the market, they're likely to continue into the weeks and months ahead. And I guess the main concern is we haven't hit the bottom yet.
These graphs aren't just confusing, they're dangerous.
Last time we saw anything like this was the global financial crisis itself.
Economic uncertainty in the US and Europe this week has seen our market dip, dive and deliver the most fluctuating figures we've seen in years. Here's the upside.
While markets are bouncing around, the Reserve Bank is not going to do anything.
With interest rates, that is, although many economists are divided on what will happen in the long term.
You should always consider fixed-term rates, but remember, the best thing is get a balance. Don't have everything fixed, don't have everything floating. If you get a mix, that's the safest way to do it.
If you're confused by all of this movement in the marketplace, don't worry, so are some of the world's leading analysts. But the basic sentiment is this. If you're a long-term investor, rest easy. But in the short term, anything can happen.
If you fancy a gamble, many believe there's never been a better time to buy.
And where there's a lot of bad news, that's where you usually find bargains. So we like JB Hi-Fi, Oriton is another business that we like. Woolworths also appears to be cheap.
Roger Montgomery advises to treat the market like a grocery store.
I turn up and when they're $7.99 a punnet, the family goes without strawberries. But when they're $2 a punnet or you get two for $4, well, what do? You take some strawberries home.
But no matter how cheap, strawberries are no good when they're rotten. And that's the risk you take entering this market. Natasha Exelby, 10 News.